Members, this is Erin Fierro, a graduate student researcher in the Levy Lab Legion, bringing you another episode of TLDR. What up? Okay, let's get to the news. Spooky Action at a Distance takes place tomorrow. Check out the link below for a gallery of the posters from our participants and when they are scheduled to present. Presentations are broken up into 6 sessions, with 3 taking place concurrently from 3 to 4 p.m. and 3 from 4:15 to 5:15. Visitors are welcome to stop in and watch presentations, but you may not have a chance to ask questions after the judges because we will be enforcing a strict schedule. For seminars this week, Dr. Andre Gromov from Brown University will give a talk in the Theoretical Physics series at CMU on fractions and vortices. Dr. Erica Carlson from Purdue University will be hosted by the Joint Pitt-CMU Physics Colloquium on Monday, November 2nd at 4 p.m. where she will discuss her work on pattern formation at the Mott metal insulator transition. Also on Monday at 10 a.m., the International Ultrafast Coffee House has invited Dr. Pin Chia Wu from the National Chung Kung University to discuss his research on optical metamaterials. Professor Zach Ulissi from CMU's Department of Chemical Engineering has partnered up with AI to assist in quantum simulations. Other collaborators include everyone through the Open Catalyst Project. The hope here is to start a little quantum galaxy zoo, encourage collaboration, and of course, take advantage of the computing power that everyone can offer. Currently, the project is particularly focused on electrocatalysts that could aid in the inevitable switch from fossil to renewable energy. The overview paper and dataset paper for this work are available on archive and linked below. For our last week of spooky news, the question has been posed, what if we're all wrong about everything? We all know that no one really knows what's up with the quantum world. There are a few rules, the math checks out, and it's pretty good at predicting stuff. But why it all happens is more of a philosophical question than a scientific one these days. One physicist, Angelo Bossi, in his desire to fuel everyone's nightmares, has been hunting for an alternative, specifically a theory that has been dubbed objective collapse model, quantum mechanics that does not rely on observation to start acting up. He is currently working on an experiment to test out this idea. We will know if it works because we will either not hear about it again or it will be in Nature. And finally, Quantum Shorts is still taking submissions, and they can be as creative as you are. Last week, we highlighted a sketch, but a video could also be more like this one called Ampersand, an animated journey from the atomic to galactic scale. It kind of reminds me of the Carl Sagan era Cosmos evolution bit, if it met house music. Reach out for help getting involved. Well, that is all for TLDR this week. Stay PQ engaged, everyone.